This 50-gallon Rheem Proterra system cost us $1,700 before installation. A comparable-sized electric tank water heater would have been about $650, $700. We want to justify the cost of that right now. So if you're building or remodeling with energy efficiency in mind, domestic hot water is a low-hanging fruit. Depending on who you ask, your hot water energy usage accounts for anywhere from 20 to 30% of your yearly energy bill. That's really huge. Using a heat pump water heater like this Rheem Proterra is a great way to slash that cost at a pretty reasonable price. When you're using a tank water heater, there's three main ways to get your energy. Well, four if you count solar. There is gas, there is electric resistance, and there's heat pump. There's also evacuated tube solar systems, which are actually crazy efficient. They're just really expensive and have almost a 15-year payback period. So we have heat pump, gas, electric. We almost always gravitate towards heat pump. They come at a slightly higher price tag. Well, not even slightly. This 50-gallon Rheem Proterra system cost us $1,700 before installation. A comparable-sized electric tank water heater would have been about $650, $700. So for all intents and purposes, this heat pump water heater costs about $1,000 more than a resistance tank water heater. Right off the bat, there's a $400 to $600 federal credit available for upgrading to a heat pump water heater. Super easy to apply for. One thing to think about, if you're working with a contractor, maybe you buy the hot water heater, talk with them first, of course, and they install it. It's much easier to get the credit that way. Next thing to consider is how little electricity they use. So our estimated yearly energy use for this hot water heater, $117. If you look here, it's so low, it's all the way to the lowest side of the scale and then lower than that. A typical electric resistance hot water heater with a 50-gallon tank can cost anywhere from $600 to $800 a year. You could have theoretically a payback in 2 years or less for the difference it costs to install one of these. That's huge. Couple that with the federal tax credit, there's almost no reason not to use one of these. If you're not already convinced, this will throw you over the edge. It's super easy to connect this hot water heater to your cell phone with the Rheem app. You can turn them on vacation mode from your phone. When's the last time you went to your basement and, you know, set that little pilot knob all the way to away mode? I've done that maybe twice. Edit that out, maybe. So if you decide to use a heat pump water heater, that's awesome. There are a couple things though you need to consider before installing one of these. The biggest thing is the amount of cubic feet required for this unit to operate properly. This has a really specific call out for a 700 cubic foot room, which we have. Take the length times the width times the height, you'll find your cubic feet. If you don't have that cubic footage, there's a couple things you can do to get it. You can actually duct in fresh air from another room. You can duct out the discharge. We don't have to do that, so we can't show you, but it's a really easy HVAC connection to make. This is a solid core wood door that we salvaged from another project for our basement mechanical room. If we had to, we could cut vents in here. If we had to, we could replace it with a louvered door. And in a big pinch, we can undercut about 2 inches off the bottom to let more airflow come in and out of the room. This is not a problem in here. This is a massive mechanical closet. If you're setting one of these up, one thing you can think about, if you're someone who stores a lot of food, has a couple chest freezers, they're gonna throw off some heat. Maybe put it right here. If you're into cryptocurrency, this might be a good place to put one of your rigs. Just saying, is that still a Dogecoin thing? We still doing that? Something else to consider if you're using a heat pump water heater is what to do with the condensate that's discharged from the unit. This works just like an air conditioner, but in reverse. There's gonna be some condensation that's pulled from the air. We actually like that a lot. It's taking humidity out of our basement. It's gotta go somewhere though. In this case, we have it plumbed right down through here. It falls all the way into our sump pump. We have a removable top that's not PVC'd, so if we need to clean this out, easy to access that. Again, we have a sump pump here. A lot of times they go into air conditioner condensate pumps that are then pumped somewhere else in the house to discharge. There is some noise associated with these units. I wouldn't put it right next to a bedroom. I would put it in a basement or in a closet that has pretty good insulation. If you're in living spaces, a little bit of sound insulation is gonna go a long way. That being said, not too loud. Right before we started filming, we found an article, switching to a heat pump water heater over a standard electric resistance water heater is the equivalent of adding 7 solar panels to your roof. And it comes at about a sixth of the cost. We'll put a link in the description for that article so you can check the numbers yourself. Math,